Okay, let's talk about the new 2020 Fireblade today. Now, if you have seen in any automobile show or even in automobile channels in the YouTube, everyone is hyped up because of this Honda new Fireblade. Now, I'm gonna be explaining you what all the things makes it so much hyped, or what are all the changes that they have made so that the new blade can compete with the newer machines like the S1000RR V4s from Aprilia and Ducatis, or the Yamaha R1 and Kawasaki ZX10R. So let's get started with the video. Now, Honda have been lagging behind from every company whichever is in the leader class position in terms of power, but in the terms of equipment or in the terms of rideability, it was performing better than the other bikes. All the track riders, whoever took it to track, were so much impressed with that. Like, it was able to exit the corner much faster than any other bike in the leader class segment. So even though it was a bit less on power, it got a pretty good response because of its size factor, and also because of its ergonomics, due to which it was able to exit or enter the corner much easier and much faster as well. Now, the 2020 blade has been taken inspiration from the $173,000 RC213V, which was the road going version of the MotoGP bike, and they have took the same bore and stroke of what they were using in RC213V, which is 81 millimeter bore and 48.5 millimeter stroke, as if which they were using in the older version was 76 mm bore and 55 mm stroke. Now, that is a big improvement over square engine that is taken from the RC213V. Now, all the changes they have been made in the engine makes it a newer engine to this year. It uses finger follow rocker arm used instead of bucket valve drive, which reduces inertia by 75%. They also used diamond like carbon or DLC on cam lobs, which reduces valve train friction by 35%. Titanium corn rods and the cats save 50% of the weight compared to steel type, which were used in the last generation Fireblade. The pistons used here are forged aluminium pistons, which also reduce 5% of weight, and the rear of the engine block serves as a rear shock mount as well. So they have removed the rear shock mount rod, so due to which they have reduced the weight of the chassis as well. Now, all these changes of the engine made the chassis to become much more lighter and compact. So that's the reason why they have opted a newer design. The newer design diamond frame chassis is made up of 2mm aluminium frame and designed for new smaller engine in dimension, with the goal of improving high speed steering and acceleration, and also while braking, which increases vertical rigidity by 18%, torsional rigidity by 9%, and decreases the horizontal rigidity by 11% to give the best track riding experience for every track rider whoever takes it to a track. Now, the placement of the crank or the engine is moved further back by 33 millimeters and taken above by 16 millimeters from the front wheel, to get the best balanced bike and to make that center of gravity exactly at the center to be more flickable, and also to take turns by a large amount of confidence. The aluminium swing arm has increased its length by 30 mm, which increases the bike's length by 622.7 millimeters like the RC213VS, but the weight of the swing arm is same as the previous generation swing arm used in the Fireblades by using 18 different types of thickness of aluminium. The seat is raised by 10 mm, which increases the height to 830 mm. The clip-ons are moved forward and the foot pegs are moved backward to form the track riding position and make easier on the track for aerodynamic purpose. And all these have made the bike to gain 5 kgs, and the weight of the new 2020 Fireblade is 201 kg, which is 5 kgs more than the previous generation blade, but it makes up by producing 13% more horsepower than the last generation blade as well. Now, when it comes in terms of equipment, Honda have improved a lot here. Now, the last generation Honda Fireblade was using 320mm front rotors, and they have improved it by 10mm and taken to 330mm front rotors, and the standard version comes with a 43mm big piston Showa forks at the front, with a Nissin calipers 4 pots at the front as well, and a Showa rear monoshock at the rear, which directly mounts onto the rear of the engine. There's electronically controlled steering dampers from Showa as well, which improves the high speed steering capabilities and makes that wobbles a little less compared to the normal steering. Now, in terms of electronics, they have ditched the 5-axis IMU and opted for the 6-axis IMU, which is the initial measurement unit. And throttle by wire technology has been improved for much crispier throttle response. Now, because of the new electronics, there are 3 types of riding modes, which also includes 5 levels of power management, 3 levels of engine braking, 3 levels of wheelie control, and also has an option of disabling as well. Traction control of 9 levels, and you can turn it off as well. It also has a launch control, which you can activate at either 6, 7, 8 or 9k RPM, and it locks the RPM by not going above that, so that you get maximum traction while launching the bike when you leave the clutch. Now, all this is controlled or displayed on the 5-inch TFT display, which displays you all the information that you need and is controlled by the switch gear, which is provided on the left side of the clip-ons. Now, if you see the cockpit, there is no keyhole because they have omitted the keyhole and opted for a keyless ignition. Now, due to which they have made possibility to get in more air into the intakes by creating an air duct from the front of the bike, which you can see at the front. Now, when you come to the aerodynamics part of the bike, they have dropped the tank by 45mm so that the rider can tuck in more and get that more efficient aerodynamic ride. Also, the mudguard is shaped in a convex shape to flow the air away from the tire, which also reduces the drag, and made as one of the most aerodynamic bike in its segment with 0.27 drag coefficient as well. Now, if you see in the bike trends which are trending now in terms of design, are those winglets, which are also present in the new Ducati Street Fighter V4 as well, in which there are 2 winglets on each side, and also in the Ducati V4R and the V4S in the same manner, 2 at each side. Also, Aprilia RS V4 1100 factory. Now, Honda have included these wings in a very smart manner, and you won't at all feel like these wings are been put up like an aftermarket accessory, and it has been very cleverly incremented into the fairings, which will improve your high speed stability as well as in the cornering as well, keeping that front end down and creating maximum amount of traction to that front wheel, so that you can make sharper turns and exit and enter the corners in a very confident way. Now, all this is standard in the standard model as well, which you will get around £20,000, which translates to around 18.5 lakhs in Indian currency. But when you go to the SP model, in which you get electronically controlled all-in suspension at the front and electronically controlled all-in TTX shock, rear monoshock as well, and the Nissin calipers at the front are emitted and put on a Brembo Stylema calipers, four pots at the front, and the Ohlins front suspension which they have used also has that pressurized Ohlins suspension which also the R1M has. Now all this has come at a price, and it has an increment from the base model which is around 23,500 pounds, which translates to around 22 lakhs in Indian currency. Now I don't know how much the Indian variant will cost, and we are waiting when they will launch in the Indian market, and a lot of enthusiasts who are a great fan of Honda motorcycles are also waiting for this bike. So make sure you comment down below whether this blade will be able to cope up with all the later class motorcycles such as the V4s of Aprilia, Ducati, and the S1000RR, the ZX10R, R1M, which all are also updated for the 2020 year as well.